G'day and welcome back to our Quit India campaign in Hearts of Iron 4. So we've had to merge these two armies down to one, and they are on, 6% average strength, roughly. So we're not going to be able to take Vladivostok. It is going to have to be the Soviets or the Finns that end up retaking it, which is fine, I guess. I mean, it would have been handed over to China either way. Well, China this way, the Soviets will get it back at the end of the war. Would have liked to have gotten the war score for it. Participation's down to 35 because of everything happening in Europe at the moment. UK's doing too much around Italy. And yeah, these guys are completely screwed. Turkey's capitulated. Well, unexpected. You know, these guys are going to sit here. We've still got the other 20 coming up. They have average strength 47%. They might be able to do something. Really, there goes the encirclement bonus. We want the Soviets to retake that before these guys arrive, which is coming very soon. Alright, what do we got? 2 days. Infrastructure is down, makes them slow. Alright, there we go. So we'll be doing a counterattack as well. It's nice, and some of these guys will be over here. That's Spanish in there. Interesting. They haven't actually joined the Axis yet. And three whole guys left here. They will join in to widen the front line combat width. Do the best they can, but really don't expect them to win. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab half of these guys and move them up. Hopefully the Soviets will keep their attack going through there. 8 days, 7 days, 6 days. So I might be able to pull it off. Depending on whether they're going to retreat over here. Or if our guys will retreat that way. 5 and 6. Think we're going to get it. Nah. But now there's an encirclement. 30% penalty for them. Nice. Soviets are going to try and come in. We should be right on the edge of pushing in, though. And we're going to kill 5 divisions of Japan, who only has 56 left. Nice. Hopefully, we got the benefit of taking that. Alright, we've got 40 in there. And more dudes up here. So, these three now can get off the Soviet border. They're just going to kind of stand in his way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there's only 3 of them in there. Better off doing this one. Hopefully there's enough Chinese around to take care of that. And our reinforcement issues, we've lost 700,000 worth of things. We need 100,000 short, which would be, 1,000 months until it comes back or something. Let's get half of these moving up. Any time we can kill 7 guys is good. Widen the line. Still only using half of it though. Everything going our way. Air support coming from... not us. Must be the Chinese. Alright, we'll win that. Nuclear reactors 25 days out. It's going to take a long time to actually build one to get the nukes coming. Each reactor is a 12-month thing for the production. Right, now, these 20 are still on there, so that's fine. These 3 will stand there and be destroyed by guys trying to come in. So, next question is, will the American fleet ever arrive? One friendly ship down there. We don't need you around the Raj. We just need you in the Sea of Japan. It's the one place that we need friendly shipping. What about the other provinces? South China Sea has 7 ships, 5 ships, 2 ships, and 7 friendlies. I mean, they're too busy taking care of the other islands, I'd say. So they've actually started doing naval invasions down here. So there's that. Yeah, doing naval invasions that way. These guys are just wandering through. Okay. No, we're going to leave them there. Let's take half of these guys down there, since they walk back by themselves. And we need an airbase. Yeah, they're trying to land on that. Okay. Empty airbases. Allied bases. Manila is the closest, 4,000 kilometers away. So, no, we're not going to get that kind of range. Without some kick-ass jet fighters. And we're nearly done on this. Oh, we've actually made a dude. Dominion of India fleet now exists with one guy. Which would be fine if there was no enemy ships there. How many Japanese? 63. Need the naval bombers. Or just the fighters might be enough to get the naval supremacy from the air. God, controlling that entire freaking ocean. We don't need to. Only place we need to control is the Sea of Japan. And I assume the Soviets are going to push down through Okhotsk, Sakhalin. They're back again. Get over there. Just doing naval invasion after naval invasion on that. And yeah, these guys are holding them back, so we're going to keep them there. Nuclear reactors, yay. Now, 75% bonus means it takes 5 days to work on nuclear bombs. Because that's just 75% bonus. And then, obviously, we're going to jump straight into building nuclear reactors in the center of our core territory. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... if at all possible. Those six up. How long was he going to take? 7th of December. Screw you, buddy. I'm going to get one done. And that will take till May of 43, plus a year for the nuke. May of 44. So pretty far ahead of time. I would say, because of those massive bonuses, India's actually able to do it faster than any other country in the game. They're all planning a Chinese invasion. Good on you, France and America. Bulgaria's capitulated, so... how is Soviet Union doing? Still roughly the same. Alright, modernized army. Research finished. Nukes. Good for us. Jungles don't matter so much. Air support. Tactical bomber. Closes air support and naval bombers. Extra naval dockyard. Was what we just had to not do. I want to finish this bit here. And Syrian factories. Not allowed to do any more. Okay. Now, the research slot. 43 is coming up. Rocketry could take care of the Japanese pretty well. UK is retaking Italy. So there's that. And they're actually pushing up through Germany now as well. Must be the American forces landing. Lots of somebody streaming in there. It's weird that nationalist Spain hasn't joined the Axis. Alright, turn that back off. It's the UK versus Germany. German convoys must be trying to get rubber. Old British battleships in there. Still a no on the Sea of Japan. But we're killing guys as they land, so he's got far fewer every time. We could let him land here and then kill them, make it faster. Currently, we're not producing any nuclear bombs. No, not until, what, May. Which means we don't care about this so much. Give us the civilian factories back. and then do that later. Okay, we lost a dude from that invasion force. Bastard. Our dudes. Organization's okay. It's a terrible strength. But killing Japanese, it's going to be worth it. What we are going to do now, though... No, we'll let them keep doing that. Let them keep landing. And this doesn't matter so much anymore. Keep them all in this one. Easier to click on it when we need it. Took it. Alright. He's got a lot more ships there now instead of less. 7 there, 2 there, 1 up there. Can't get through without Sea of Japan. You know what we could do? No, I like the idea of these guys holding them back. Let's do it with one guy then. Let's go for a naval invasion. Down there. Alright, 57th Indian Division. You shall invade from here to here. And then try and take the port. And then, you know, do the rest of your stuff. It's not set up perfectly, but sure. 3 days, taking longer than that just to arrive. And average strength here, 3%. Alright, reinforcement issue. What's the upgrade for? Infantry equipment. Fair enough. Yeah, 100,000 manpower under. Alright, speed 5 for a bit. And the Japanese landed again. Should we keep pushing them back? I think we should. Oh, you're going the wrong way, you idiot. This way first, and then come around there. Yeah, Chinese doing it for us. Alright. Go from there to there. He's getting his organization up. Alright, just avoid that river crossing. And Japan have only extensive conscription, so you should be able to do more. Must have trouble actually manufacturing them. Alright, this dude, no organization and no strength. He's going to jump on a boat. Thanks to the one friendly ship present down there. And, yeah, he's going to die. Which is fine. Alright, as soon as he lands, manually handle him. He's not going to be able to get out of there again. Alright, you, buddy. You're going to take as much of this island as you can and then stand there staring at them. Alright, good army experience. How much have we done now? 30%. Yeah, it's going to drop a lot after that whole mess in Italy. I'm looking at April now. They're just going to retake everything behind us. They'll never leave the port to let us out, so that dude's just dead. How are we looking up here? He's still got 13 ships. We only have one. Alright, Grand Assault. Ooh, huge bonuses. So, UK and Australia went that way. Canada went that way. We want leg stuff. Leg breakthrough in one day. Don't know where they get the percentages from. UK and Australia have done this. That's 149 days. You have 0 research slots available. Alright, in the shipyard. Then, naval doctrine and other stuff we don't particularly care about. You know what we could do? Start doing this stuff. The civilian factories, because we don't care about the, breaking free at the moment. Doesn't say how many points over we are. You could add it up, I guess. 7, 6, 13, 14, 33 or so. Alright, so we definitely lose a couple of hundred and still be able to break free when we wanted. Let's take a look at Europe. Ah, Soviets pushing back. There we go. Pushing back through Western Poland into actual Germany now. France still doing its thing. Italy working out. Balkans surrounded. It's like Comintern took chunks of Turkey in the capitulation. Holy crap. Pushed out of Libya. Alright, send you to shipyard. Do we want the air support thing? Tactical bombers, CAS, and naval bombers. We could do a naval bomber thing. Bangalore torpedoes. Don't know what that is. The infantry division in Delhi. Sounds fine. Let's get one more division. Because somebody that might be of some use. These guys are now stuck up there. They can just sit in Taipei. Unless they have supply there. An aggression from China is a no. Alright, that is crazy high defense. 300% modification due to things that don't add up to anything like 300%. So we certainly need one of them there. Put the other guy down there and see if we can stop the naval invasions altogether. Alright, less than 200k in the field. Even if we could get rid of the marginalised Muslim community, don't know if we would be able to do that by releasing Pakistan. No, I don't think it would count. Yeah, nothing that'll really help. He held off naval invasion. It's awesome. The Chinese guy's there is waiting now anyway. Wu Bingqi. And too many enemy ships. Still just got one. And yeah, they just can't deploy. I don't see any way to get around that. It's all going to be about dropping the nuke, getting the achievement, breaking free, and then trying to do other stuff, like slaughtering Japan. Who are the major countries in here? Where do we have to see it? Not there. Wargol. It says it somewhere. Hover over them. Yeah, Italy is not a major faction anymore. I guess he's recapitulated anyway. Yep. So we can take out Japan. And then somebody should be able to handle Germany. Soviets have broken him. The POMs are pushing in. Yeah, lots of numbers there. Alright, he is now all out at serve. So he isn't scraping the barrel yet. So he's probably still got some good production going on. Want to see a fight, see how strong they are. Yeah. The Germans, fighting strength 50%. Okay, and the POMs are high, and 200 men, 200 divisions, ask for control of state, could ask for chunks. You know, it would be fun, would be if we were to take Württemberg. Can we get over Bayern yet? No, we can get Tyrol. That's asking too much. Can't even ask one. Alright, forget that. Alright, research into rocketry. 250 days. Still a bit of a mixed bag in Europe. Especially with the Germans just pushing out Italian territory. Although, they are coming in behind. We retake the Suez. Alright, 13 ships. Mariana, two. Just needing to push up that little bit more. He's trying to see. Yeah, we can't do it with one ship. Can't get planes in. As we check that. It's Saipan. Is there a go-to? No. Alright. Well, they've taken another island somewhere around there. Marcus Islands. Hey, United States. Why can't we put men in there? No. Should be allowed to. Oh, well, I'm going to take a short break here. So, thanks for watching. Hope you're enjoying it. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I hope to see you again soon for, hopefully, eventually, the invasion of Japan. Or just nuking somewhere. You know, we actually need to make one of those planes. But, see you later.